Alright guys, how you doing? This is Lucreme from the Milwaukee Airport here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, home of the 2020 Democratic National Convention. Next week on Monday, August the 24th through August the 28th, I will be in Charlotte, North Carolina, doing first aid services as well as helping out the media, working for free in Charlotte, North Carolina. And then on Friday, I will go to Washington, D.C. to help out Al Sharpton and his campaign. His National March on Washington in Washington, D.C. for the 50th anniversary of the National March on Washington in remembrance of Dr. Martin. All right, so we have scheduled the agenda for the RNC. They don't have to do it for Monday, but on Tuesday it's going to be playbook co-authors Jake Sherman and Anna Palmer. We'll go ahead and let people see what's going on for that, as well as video journalist Eugene Daniels will be from Foursquare. He will be doing speaking at the RNC, as well as political correspondent Tim Roberta, chief of Washington correspondent in D.C., Ryan Litza, and political reporter Laura Barron Lopez. They will speak on Tuesday night the 25th, on Wednesday the 26th, and Charlotte, North Carolina. There will be Jay Sherman and Anna Palmer, as well as Senatorial Committee Kevin McGaughan will also be speaking at the RNC in Charlotte, as well as talking about how the electoral map is going to look like in Florida. Florida is a really big, big one for our Republicans, which usually Florida belongs to Republicans every 4 years. So right now, the big, big major cornerstones for the RNC, for the Democrats as well as Republicans, is going to be a major, major key blackstone. It's going to be New York State, of course, Illinois, California, of course Texas usually goes conservative, and then of course Florida. Some other good ones we have are Iowa, Idaho, Utah, as well as we're going forward towards Washington, and then over more Midwest. The Midwest is some other big, 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 big states for those delegate counts. It's where the popular vote is needed to win the Republican national, which is needed to remember both the Democratic as well as the Republican nomination. Then on Thursday, we have Playbook Core Authors Jake Sherman and Anna Palmer. And then there will be some more views on that, as well as Chief Economic Correspondent Ben White will be hosting on Friday at 1 o'clock. And then we have Tim Roberta, Chief, the schedule is pretty much the same next week. So let me check the DNC here. Otherwise, pretty much I'll be providing the same services there. I'll probably have a table set outside to greet some of the RNC people there in Charlotte, North Carolina, letting them know about first aid, hands and attacks, and medical services, as well as checking with the local Charlotte Police Department, as well as the local hospital facilities that are available within the facilities that the Charlotte Police will be hosting at. So go ahead and correlate with the Charlotte Police Department, as well as with the North Carolina State Police, and also with the local hospital and facility staffs that are available to help with the local people that are going to be in Charlotte. And also, let me see. Look back forward to. I know you guys are here at home, and I'm here in the airport in Milwaukee. There's a couple other things I have to look forward to. Of course, going out there and getting the day, being on Nice and Daisy, but you have to look forward towards your future and towards your career goals, which you pretty much want in life. A lot of things to look forward to towards this fall semester 2020 starting here, coming up. And right now, today is August the 19th, Wednesday, August the 19th, 2020, here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. School is about to be starting on August the 18th. School probably has started for a lot of you guys here this week, as well as college semesters are about to be starting, but most of the college agendas, as well as the academic course load, is going to be pretty much virtual for a lot of students. Harvard University is going to be having a lot of other courses online, as well as Princeton, Stanford. They're going to be offering a lot of their coursework online for the major Ivy League schools as well. But Harvard, as well as Stanford, is still, and some of the major Ivy League schools are still offering in-person classes, okay? So there's a lot of other events and interests going on, okay? NBA season had just started 2 weeks ago, so the NBA, what the NBA and the local sports are doing. Tennis is still on Wimbledon, the championships, the free, all that stuff. Tennis is still good. Golf is pretty much starting its regular season. Baseball is still starting its regular season, as well as a couple of the other sports, but football is still on the ends and odds. But pretty much preseason football, I'm not really sure about. But what's going on with the NBA, what I've heard is that the National Football League, the National Basketball League, is hosting all of his home games, as well as preseason, and as well as pretty much the finals, going to be hosted in Orlando, Florida. So what it is, a lot of the teammates, the big guys, Lakers, Miami Heat, the Houston Rockets, all the major big NBA players are hosting most of their home games, as well as most of the games are going to be held, the home and away games are going to be held in Orlando, Florida. And then from there, they will be only allowed to invite one guest to the NBA games in Orlando, Florida. So one guest per player. So due to COVID regulations, the NBA is really strict on letting its players be exposed, have any outkind of influence and exposure to COVID. So they only are allowing one family guest, or one guest per team member, to the stadiums in Orlando, Florida. Which is great, but we still get to watch football, but there are a lot of other issues that we need to be focusing on due to COVID. So I'm really glad we're actually able to still celebrate LeBron James and Steph Curry. But of course, we cannot forget Kobe Bryant. Rest him and his family, Vanessa, and his two younger girls that are still here alive. Kobe Bryant, may his memory be rested in peace. There's also a lot of other issues to talk about. We are still losing a lot of people. We lost Senator John Lewis. We lost a senator, famous TV talk show host, Regis Philbin, and a lot of other people this year. So, you cannot forget we lost those people due to COVID or other issues in your family. Please give me your prayers. So, there are a lot of things we need to talk about, guys. I'm here at the Milwaukee Airport, still going through a lot of stuff right now. Keep me in your thoughts and prayers. I still need to pretty much focus on what I gotta do and just be arrived. I'm not at the convention, but I'm here at the airport, so I'll be here at the airport for the next 24 hours until 11 o'clock on Thursday, and I will be departing back to Boston. From Boston, I'll be in Boston for 3 days, and then we'll be arriving in Charlotte on Monday, working again with Charlotte Police Authorities, as well as with the local hospital facilities in Charlotte, just to make sure that the RNC and the DNC are both together and correlated together on the same page, so that we don't have any issues like we did with, of course, Herman McCain, who recently passed away at a Trump rally event in Tulsa, Oklahoma, due to exposure to the COVID virus. So rest in peace, Herman McCain, a former leader. So guys, just really make sure that you and your family are both, they should have your masks on as well. You guys are pretty much protected and isolated. If you are showing any kind of symptoms of COVID, you have a temperature over 99.5, or you have a sore throat, a runny nose, a fever, any kind of body chills, please go to your nearest emergency room and get tested, as well as a lot of other issues going on here, exposure to people everywhere, even here at the airport, as well as your local neighborhood, your local park, and your street. Please be careful and take care of yourself. Okay, so this is LaQueen Battle from Battle First Aid Responding Services. The program is about to start here tonight, 7 o'clock. The Democratic National Convention will start here live in Milwaukee at 7 o'clock, and I will be still here at the airport, figuring out what's going on and try to be involved here virtually that way. All right, guys, keeping your thoughts and prayers with me.